sign political correctness is dying. My favorite show is coming back on the air. They've been showing it sporadically on MSNBC, To Catch a Predator with Chris Hansen. I love that show. You can learn so much about guys. First of all, it shows how cheap we are. These guys show up like a bag of sandwiches. Every guy has like a plastic bag with sandwiches, like some smoking 18-year-old is gonna tongue your balls because you stopped off at Quiznos, you know? She's like, I'm not gonna sleep with you. I'm saving myself. Is that a Tuscan turkey on Parmesan rosemary bread? Ooh. Is that a 6-inch tuna on wheat with pickles? Somebody's up for anal this evening, huh? Good for you. A pizzone? Let me take my shirt off. Let's get busy. It's the same show every week. The guy comes in the house. He's looking for the cameras. That means he's seen the show before and he's still risking his life. Man, what could happen, really? And he's in total denial, right? He's like, well, I guess her dad collects boom mics. And the girl's always acting busy. She's like, I have to bring these clothes down to the dryer, but I made you some sweet tea on the table over there. What is with sweet tea and pedophiles? They see that shit, it's like cheese to a rat. Is that sweet tea? I'll go to prison for 1,000 years. I don't give a crap, that stuff is delicious. And that's when Mr. Cockblock comes around the corner. Chris Hansen, the most despicable white person on the face. What an arrogant douche this guy. He's so arrogant, I'm actually pulling for the pedophiles by the end of the show. He doesn't come around the corner until he waits for like a clever opening. Like the pedophile will say to the girl, I brought you some ice cream. He comes around the corner, did you bring me some ice cream? Why don't you have a seat? And what do these guys do? They sit down. Get the hell out of there, asshole! You're about to commit a felony! They're like, oh, maybe I'll get on local news. Okay, I'll sit down and chat for a while. Guy looks like David Caruso. Maybe I can... So, what are you doing here, sir? Nothing. I'm here to meet the girl... What girl? The girl Tammy I met on the internet the other night. Really? So what were you going to do with Tammy? Nothing. I'm just here to talk to her. You sure? Yeah, I'm here to talk to her. I swear to God. So you drove, what, 5.5 hours with no pants on? 6 gallons of hair gel on your head. Yeah, you're going to talk to her? I swear to God, I was not here to do anything, sir. I'm here to talk to her. I wasn't going to do anything. Really? What do you got in the bag? Two-headed dildo, stick of butter, and a sewing kit. Blowtorch, can of chunky soup, a Devo hat, some razor blades, some Coke, can of silly string, 1,000 grapes, and some Cool Whip. Huh. Well, should be an interesting chat, shouldn't it, huh? So how old are you, sir? Well, I'm 40. And how old's Tammy? Well, she said she was 18. No, it says in the transcript she said she was 13. Oh, was that a 3? I couldn't see through my dirty computer screen. It looked like an 8, I swear to God. So let me get this straight, sir. You're 40 and she's 13. Do you think that's right? At that point, he's got the transcripts. He's got you dead to right. So just come clean. Be an asshole about it. Hey, what the fuck does right have to do with it? I'm 44 years old. I'm an unemployed electrician from Albany. I got web feet, acne in my ass, small dick, bad mustache. You think the pussy wagon pulls up in front of my house and beeps the horn every goddamn morning? I gotta do what I gotta do, Chris. Now turn that camera around, get me with her in the hot tub, and burn me a copy.